KRC is putting up an online system where such cases are going to be reported, and then they will be sent to respective people in different areas of responsibility to respond. So we are going to do that. Some of you could be actually part of this early warning mechanisms, because we want information. And since you guys are in the media, you'd be the best persons actually to do this job. That on top of your daily media engagements, you can also identify these issues and report upon them, so that we don't allow situations that can culminate into violence to eat up our society. We are going to participate in election observation. We are going to do election monitoring, then hold post-election dialogues with unsuccessful candidates at district level. Why are we interested in the unsuccessful candidates? Who can tell me why? Yes. Yes. Yeah, they could be having good ideas which we want to build on, but yes.
To avoid conflicts.
Yes, to avoid conflict. Yes.
Yes, there could be sources of conflicts because of the defeat. Now the challenges are around.
Yes. A person who has lost an election in Uganda is actually a very dangerous person. Do you accept to that? How many of you have ever lost an election? Some people are perennial losers. Okay, in Uganda, and it is a myth that we must fight to get away with, or to get away from our mindset. An election in Uganda is a do or die thing. It is a bottom line. People sell everything, people mortgage their entire life because of an election. And when this person who has mortgaged everything, he has sold everything, loses the election, he does not lose an election alone, but he also loses hope. And he becomes a very, very dangerous person. When we are doing an inception in Kasese here, there's a reverend who actually said that candidates at any election level should not only give us their manifesto during the election period, but they should also give us a manifesto after election. So, if you have gone through, what do you want to do for us? If you have not gone through, still, what do you want to do for us? Eh? Because the candidates' manifestos, especially after failing, it is more of violence and destruction. Because they have lost an election and they have lost hope. So we want to target them, and we want to have an honest discussion with them at all levels, at MP level, at the district level, at councillor level, at yes, we want to have a discussion. Please don't inflame society because you have not gone through. Your life does not start and stop with an election. You have a life to live, but also other people have a life to live. It does not make sense for you to destroy society simply because you have lost an election. So we want to have those discussion forums for people who particularly have lost hope because they have lost an election, so that we can be able to restore hope. We can make them understand that beyond an election, there is a life to live. There is, should be a role somebody plays in society, even when he has lost an election. So that is a very, very important activity that we are looking forward to. Then we are also looking at holding post-election dialogues with the successful candidates. We started with the unsuccessful ones, but we shall also not leave behind the successful one. Because now these are our leaders. And we want to put to them that it is our responsibility. Or we also want to make them understand that leadership is actually service to society. Leadership is a responsibility. Away from the thinking that when you are elected into a leadership position, then you are fallen into things. No, it is actually a service. It is a responsibility. We want to put this in their minds. But we also want to make them understand their roles and responsibilities as leaders. We want to make them transcend the divisions, the anger that came with the campaigns, that came with the electoral process, and when we put it to them that now you are the leaders of the people. Even if somebody not vote for you, but you are his or her leader, you must listen to them. And you must listen more even to those who do not even believe in you and understand why they don't believe in you. And then pick those ideas that can make you a better leader to serve everybody. We shall do that. Then we're also going to organize creative advocacy activities countering hate and dangerous speech in the 4 participating districts. We are going to come down to the community level and engage in creative advocacy. And we're going to do this through sports, through drama, okay? Sports like football, because football brings all of us together.
Now operations in Bunyoro region, we are in Kakumiro, Chukwube, and Hoima. We crossed over to West Nile, where we are in Yumbe, Madiokolo, and Terego. And we are also in Lango sub-region, particularly Lera district and Lera city. And then we are in Lamuo, that is northern Uganda, particularly Palabek refugee settlement. So by the mere fact that we have expanded to these areas, Kabarole Research and Resource Center will remain in the papers and in the documents. So the generations that come after us may not be able to define what KRC is, just like many of us do not know CARE, because previously CARE was caring for American refugees in Europe, which no longer appears today. So they also transformed to remain CARE. So KRC will remain KRC Uganda. So for the generations coming, the word Kabarole may just remain in the historical documentation. So we have field offices in Bunyoro, field offices in West Nile, field offices in northern Uganda, Rwamwanja, Chaka. So we have coordination offices. But our headquarter offices remain in Fort Portal. We also have a national coordination office in Kampala. Our thematic areas have also expanded a little bit. Governance, policy, and advocacy includes aspects of peace and also humanitarian setting. We have a youth hub that is also looking at the youth voice. We also now have under food security and agribusiness, looking at new technologies for nutrition, but also looking at nutrition of animals. So currently we are also looking at animal and plant nutrition based in Bomba, and then we also have the IRC Information Research and Communication, and the newest department is Environment and Energy, E&E, which focuses on promotion of institutional saving, energy saving technologies, and both at institutional level but also at community level. So a number of these interventions will be coming in some of these districts. Currently in Kasese, we only have 2 programs that are running. There's a new program on Vibrant that is focusing on vanilla, so that has started. So that is what I can talk about in Kasese now, but also the Young Africa Works program. So briefly, that is the new dimension of KRC. So basically, about today, I want to run through, like I said, this is not a training. Some of these I'm going to do popcorn. just touch, and then we shall have, they will be leading us to a deeper reflection, which we are going into. Conflict, just a quick hint. Conflict, many of us know it from the negative perspective, but conflict is three way. It is normal, it is neutral, and it is natural. So there is nothing negative, there is nothing positive, but the outcome is what becomes either positive or negative. But conflict is natural, normal, and neutral. So people who say that you're causing conflict, so always ask them, am I causing, is it because I am normal, is it because I am natural, or is it because I am neutral? So it should be clear on which conflict am I causing. But briefly, we cannot coexist if we were just flat. This world would be boring without men. And this world would also be boring without women. Not so. Imagine we are all men. Actually, I want to tell you, colleagues, that we struggle to ensure that we have women in this group. At least Kafi, we are very purposive. You have Barbara and the other colleagues. But for me, in the resort, in this other region, Toro, all the media people I was getting were all men. PDs, news editors were all men. Post political program hosts are all men. Then I was like, where are women?
We have Doreen.
No, by the way, I came to Doreen in the last Doreen, Irene, who else? Bridget. They were thrown to me. David, there is this one. After, actually, I also realized, I started mobilizing for this activity last week. And I realized that I don't have women on the team, I think, on Thursday. Yesterday or Wednesday. That's when I was scratching my head, where are women? Because our lead partner is the women agents, they're going to be very tough on me.
Yeah, I see one. So, was the same story
inside. So, you see, the media, I don't know, the good thing we have PDs here, program directors, CEOs of these online programs and the rest, platforms, try to look at how you bring these women on board. It's very important. So, as part of that, I wanted to tell you that two or more parties, or individuals or organizations that have differences. Naturally, it is a conflict, naturally. I am here dressed in, this is cream, I don't know, I'm colorblind, and navy blue. But if I was putting on one color, it would be something very unique. If it was just one color, everyone would be looking at me different, like my colleague is putting on a suit. But the reason we mix is to bring out the smartness, and in English, we call these colors being in conflict. They are conflicting colors, so they bring out a bigger picture, a good picture. I talked about having women and men, it's a conflict, but we are living together. Our body parts, we eat food, but we push it out. So it's positive, you take it in, but also the opposite part, you bring it out. So imagine we're just putting in food inside and not putting it out. So that is, that's why conflict is natural, that's why conflict is normal, and that's why conflict is neutral. The outcomes of it is the problem. Just quickly, it also depends on which side you are to determine whether conflict is good or bad. So it depends on where you're standing. That's why they say one's perpetrator may be a victim on the other side. So you call yourself a victim, but the other party calls you what? A perpetrator. So it depends on which angle, the same applies to conflict. Which angle are you standing on? Sam was talking about ethnicity, minority, and all that debate. The question is if you're calling yourself a minority, then who should not call him or herself a minority? So you'll find that even the majority are saying we are minorities. Are we together? I have been in areas which have almost the highest population in some of in a district. But the word is, we are a minority. But they are a majority. But also the minority who are small are also saying, we are a minority. So you ask yourself, who is a minority, who is a majority? And even now in this country, a lot has changed as we headed 2026 elections. Our political actors are struggling. Where do we place this? Where do we put this? Because the resources are few, but the demands are high, and everybody shows I am in need. Everybody says government correctly? MPs are saying government correctly? ministers are saying the same. So the question is, whom should government help? You get it? It depends on which side you are standing. The same applies to conflict. So it depends on which side you are standing that you call yourself. You either see the other party as the perpetrator or as a victim.
My name is Andrew Rumba Katusabe. Atenye, I come from Bunyangabu. For those of you who know Bunyangabu, my primary school, I used to study with a lot of Wakonzo from the mountains, Kivota and so on. Rubona primary school. Huh? So I know most of you people. If I don't know you, I know your brother, whom I studied with, or your sister. We used to play football from before you reach Kisomoro here. What's that? Kabata? No. Before you reach Kisomoro and Kibito. There's that playground. Busita. Hey, that's where our competitions would be when I was in primary. You know? So I am a child of this Toro sub-region, isn't it? I am an investigative journalist. I am the CEO of the Spy Uganda and Detective UG. Those are online newspapers. If you doubt my words, you go, all of you are on your phones, smartphones, go on your Google and put in the Spy Uganda or Detective UG, they will come, isn't it? The Spy Uganda, these are online newspapers together with Detective UG. I'm the president of Independent Online Journalist Association. In brief, you can say INDOJA. INDOJA is an association that brings together online journalists. I'm executive member of National Association of Broadcasters, NAB. I represent online media on NAB executive. But I'm also the founding speaker and chairman of the Pan-African Pyramid. Now, let's go to the main issue now that brought us here. How can media play a role in creating peaceful and non-violent before, during, and after elections? This is our core now for today. Remember, I said the theme is promoting the culture of peace before, during, and after. This is the theme. Promoting the culture of peace before, during, and after. This is the theme. So, I was just trying to give you a insight of what you're supposed to do as a journalist. So, even during elections, you see now your role is even increasing. During elections, you have a very, very, very critical role to play. First of all, in Ugandan politics and African politics in general, it is the politicians who shape the narrative. Am I lying? Tell me that I'm lying.
In
most cases, it is the politicians who shape the narrative. If you go by that, as a journalist, you are going to be writing on your camera's back. It is the politician writing. That's why most of your registration, you even start promoting the manifesto of a particular politician that you support. The news you read is skewed towards the person that you support. You are already on his back. Now you have left the society. You have left the room. You are with the politician. Just for elections are in 2026, but 2025 is an electionary period or year. The media
is supposed to be playing a key role. Right now, you should be working with the NGOs, partners, and the government. We should be now preparing the minds of the citizens. Why do we want to elect people? Which positions are due for election? Well, civic education, mainly media plays a key role. Because, my friend, I was covering elections in 2011 in Kamwenge. At night, I captured a story, photos of an aspiring MP. At night, you people, this is very dangerous. Government in America gives a very big budget to media, especially the big media, the CNN, BBC, and so on. They give them a lot of money because they want them to do their job. But also, politicians, they always want those media outlets to champion their agenda, especially in the international geopolitics. In the international geopolitics, there was BBC will always stand with UK's interests. BBC. They only bring in the Africa perspective where you are weak. And they give you 1 minute. Then BBC report about BBC, about UK. They will give themselves 5 minutes. Then they give some seconds to Africa. An African abandoned. You know? And they always shoot. When I watch these things, they see them. So, why?
Because they know that media is a big tool. Now, I want to encourage you, comrades, that elections are coming. Let us play a pivotal role of sensitization, civic education, being balanced, being fair.
And for me, where you live in Kampala, as media, as journalists, we always accept challenges to learn new things. Now we are called netizens. We who are online, we are called, we sleep, we are called netizens. Yes, now, there is right now called citizen journalism. Everybody now with the judges on the smartphone.
Yes.
So it has to be one thing I know. First day, I grew up in Toro. The only source of information was VOT, or really, how is it VOT? But then, VOT is recently the online media, and very sure they can read news. Now, if you only media, if the only media, let me finish this one. If the only media does not understand the position in which they are standing or seated, you give wrong information. VOT brings it. The rest of the world, what? The rest of it. In the long run, you are pushing a wrong narrative in society, and this entire society is going into a wrong direction. So the role of media, and now more especially online media, because now everybody is online, news run faster online media than the traditional media. The screenings in Kampala, we hold them almost every other time we get an opportunity. We must remind ourselves of our responsibility. In Rwanda, every citizen, youth, before you join university, after finishing senior six, they take it for a national course. Do you know what they teach there? Do you know? Do you have a Rwanda here? Do you have a Rwanda here? And you can understand.
I'm going to go to the
They are what they call national interests. Yeah? national interest, especially national security. Things that may affect the stability, the national security, the interest of a country, journalists are the first people at least to be aware of. Just like in any other media, when you watch Russia right now, specific news, all the Russian media, they are promoting the interests of Russia in Ukraine. Those may not be necessarily correct. When you watch VOA, Voice of America, Sky News, when you watch something become critical, what most interests are promoting? They are promoting the interests of America here in Ukraine. It does not mean that they are necessarily correct. Now, between Russia's interests and America's interests, fighting in Ukraine, who is suffering? Who? The poor people, the public, the spread, those people. That's why the media is losing it, the international media. Nobody is speaking for them. For the poor. All of them are speaking for those with interests. National interests of Russia, national interests of America. Now, what about the interests of the Ukrainians in the battlefield? Now, do you understand the role, the political role in such situation? The same thing here in Kampala, in Uganda, during, or even before, pre-elections, during elections, after elections, you must play a political role. Be impartial. Be factual. I have had eavesdrops that some of our journalists in the region are beginning to guard, they are trying to guard against certain politicians who may not necessarily say what makes you happy, you know, what makes you happy, but it is his opinion. In our opinion, just go to the supermarket here. Those are opinions. You go to the supermarket, you see there is everything. Everything. You pick what defeats you. Those are opinions. When you thank God people for their opinions, now you have left journalism. Because journalism has its own ethics. Let me tell you people. Let me tell you. Last week I interviewed a man called General Babeju. Babeju is a general fighting in health against the invasion. Against the invasion. Nobody can say the not to let the
saying.
You know what I'm saying?
She's
going to Babeju's war. Oh, there's a general fighting in Haiti. He's a Haitian. He's a fighting against the invasion, the Kenyan forces by UNU and America. I gave him an opportunity to speak. Why? Because the people of America are oppressing the opinions of other people and monopolize those are citizens of Haiti. If you're on phone after here, go to www.panafricanjeremy. You will see that interview there. www.panafricanjeremy.com, YouTube chat. You see that interview with Babeju. I have been looking for point to interview him. If you have contact for call, give me the contact. I want to hear his opinion. That is a journalist's effort. You don't know, if you are not listening to point, you are not interacting with him. Please leave some space to blame him. That's not his opinion. If you have not listened to Al-Shabaab command, I don't think that Al-Shabaab command.
Yes,
if you are near the road, give me the water. This is happening. As a journalist, you know what? You have to make a lot of money. You have started journalism to do journalism. That man called the court, that man called Al-Shabaab, they have a reason why they are waiting. Listen to you. You may not agree with it. It's not your responsibility to agree with it. During the 1996 war, some media outlets never agreed to say this war. Today, all of you are saying yes. You must. But during those days, when he was the minority, do you remember the election of 1990? What? So the MLA leaders would not even want to give him a command for 1 million. Now, I don't care.
So he put his own
people.
What about the white?
I don't know. So now, their problem is at the time, if they were there, who didn't see that the person had something to say? So you get that? So never become a judge. Your job is to be impartial. Be impartial. You give the narrative that they got. I would get that. Even those who don't agree, we will give them an opportunity to explain themselves as a generalist. Then you have done
your job.
That is your job, that's what it ends. Forces of wrong will do their part. The security of the country will do their part. Civil society organizations like this one of KRC, with them, they are funded. They are paid to do what they are doing. Let them do their part. They are paid. You get it? Security forces are paid. They are trained to do what they do. Many of the personnel during the war, the great persons from there catered for. Even the laws of every country catered for them to come and do their part. Journalists, you also have your part. Play your part impartially. Do not fall on anything. The mind in the middle. Play your part before, during, and after elections. Your role is not to cause conflict, but also you want the judge to say this one is wrong, this one is right. That's not your role. Lastly, as a winner,
the world is evolving. The world is evolving. Like I told you, I grew up here listening only to you. Today I have 1,000, you know, news platforms to compare notes. We are talents also, let us embrace learning and everything. Okay, as it opens, I was simply saying this is my last bit
probably. I was saying, right now, we need to be more cautious because you are one person. Well, but if you don't take full control of your media house, what you may cause, I'm sure if you cause a problem here that is of a serious concern, you will not be the one to put out the fire. You leave it for somebody else. And now it's a security. But it is you as the judge who causes the fire. But when the fire backlashes, now you say, me, I'm a journalist. I've got the security. So you leave it to the security. Yet you are not part of when you are ready. Even you don't consult them when you are ready. So we must be cautious with our tools now
in our midst. So I was showing you, this is a story I just wrote this morning. I just wrote it this morning. Sorry? What did you say? Huh? No, for me, I'm different, my dear.
I am the CEO, but my editor, my reporter, I in Kampala, they are different. So my job is to okay
the story. So when I'm saying I did, it is not that me. Yeah? For us, we're a full-fledged media house. So this story, let me give you an example. This story, we wrote it yesterday. Yesterday, sir. Sir, you see? You see the views? This is one story of views. Yesterday, sir. How many are those? You are not seeing it? Let me increase. Mitwaro ikumina mukaga, 120 people. views. One story I wrote it yesterday. By end of the year, it will be in millions of views. But what I want to present to you is this. They are across the globe, across the world. If you are a radio station in Kasese, you are serving this community. Oh, there is another radio station in Fort Porto, VOT. There is another one in Kiyotepa, there is another one in Israel. Now, the online media is serving not only Uganda, but the entire world. That gives you more power in your hands. So you must handle it with caution. With caution. That is my argument. You need to understand that you are so powerful that you can cause a conflict among the countries in 1 minute. In 1 minute. There was a tension between Uganda and Rwanda. Imagine it was reported by media. Because our job is Kagambo Gambere, Museveni Gambere, and Moslo Gambere. Then, so in 1 minute, you can. So we must be cautious of how we use our power. Finally, I want to congratulate you, journalists. If you're a journalist, I want to tell you that all these are the three arms of government cannot work properly without you. Give yourself a round of applause. After giving yourself a round of applause, please realize that you have a lot of powers in your hands, and so you must use them with caution. And thank you very much.